Hello, welcome to another one of our Studio Central live art demos. We're across the hall from Studio Central, where you can come in person and follow our workshops every day at 2 o'clock. But for those that can't make it in person or want to hang out when we're you're not able to, we are here with our live art demos. We're at Upbeat Artworks, which is our gallery and boutique of alumni art. So we're going to show off some of that before we get into it. We have a pretty fun painting today. So I'll flip the camera around and Kate can show off some of our prints.
Hello. The last group that graduated made very interesting prints for everyone to enjoy and here in the store. So I will show the selection first, mm-hmm. and then we could just move around the store and check on what's here. The first one is the ink painting that is called I Know Brushes from Luca Giorgica.
Luca's colors are so bright all the time. I love that.
So if you want some brightness, that's definitely here.
Yeah.
There is another one, Nutraghetti in Bokor. I hope I spell it correctly. It's from Romanian, so it was a translation. If you want to know more about this piece, you can ask. The Everlasting Gobstopper from Kathy Bruce.
This piece is so interesting.
And this
too.
Piece is on the wall.
Yeah,
it's actually
the
not a vertical piece, but I just matched it with another piece that is vertical, and
yeah.
that is called Intertwined Hearts.
Yes.
Another print from the same artist, it's called Moon, and we will enjoy the piece, the original, soon in the store.
Yes.
The world famous hockey player from Yvette Rochon.
So cute.
Art from Kaiser Elfontaine.
It's very clean work. Always.
And we have it in the store as well. And another one is, the original is not in the store, but we do have the print, and it's called Clay Heads.
Yes. Such a cool piece.
A very cute pink tiger. So this is not a real tiger. It's painted to remind you of a plush toy.
Mm-hmm.
It's very cute. It's Yvette's piece.
The original is also available with that one, yeah?
Yeah, it has the vibe that many would enjoy. Maybe not many, I don't know. It's so personal, it's hard to say, but it's cute.
They're all very different. There's something for everyone in here.
Always Shining from Jack Ross.
Yes.
And we had this piece for some time, and you can see the original. Worms for Brains, the original is in the store as well.
Very fun piece. I think that one's so...
The Black and White Spirit Wolves from Trevor Hodgson.
Yes. And again,
and
another one we
is...
have the original one of.
Yeah, we have the original at in the archives that we have,
mm-hmm.
so it's not in the store right now, but if you want to check on the website, you would find it there soon when we get the new website.
Yeah.
So we are switching to a new website, and the old website does not have, we do not put it online yet, so
yeah.
you will be able to see it.
But hopefully once we get the new website, it'll be a lot smoother and easier to navigate. Fingers crossed.
Yeah, so we're very excited about that. So you could definitely see all the prints in the store,
yes.
Here or there. Some of them are in the bin.
Yes.
So if you want to find, sorry, if you want to find the prints in the store, you need to dig a little bit for some of them. One
yes.
of them is not shown because of the, the image it is, you can inquire about that piece from Jack Ross.
Yeah, so here are some of the newer pieces as well as some of the ones we've had for a while from other groups. There's good variety of prints. They're nice because they're a bit more easy to get your hands on than an original piece. Okay.
And we do not have a lot of prints. They were not printed in a huge quantity, so if you want to get one of this, the more we have is nine. So it's the biggest.
Yes.
Some of them are just one or two. Found out that it's comfortable to paint behind the camera.
Yes.
So this is what I can paint for paints. And what we're doing today, we have our beloved that we never seen in person, but we've seen photos from Marissa. And if you know Marissa, you know, she shared some of her favorite photos. So this is Monty.
Monty Montgomery, if you will. I love that picture so much. Ooh, that one's nice too. He's so fluffy. Okay. Oh my goodness. He's such a beautiful dog. Little man. He's a little man. And we're back to the first one.
So I think all I wanted to paint this.
I want that one so badly. It's so cute.
And I'm still choosing because I thought all of them are great for painting. I thought of this first. Then I looked into this one. You can see the eyes better here.
Yeah. So that's nice. Photo.
No, this one is a little bit of a challenge because I would need to actually paint it on this thing probably, so it doesn't really bother that a little piece is not on the canvas.
Yeah.
Or I could reimagine a little piece here, or I could ask Marissa what was going on.
I think he has four legs and a tail. You can see from other photos. I'm not just assuming this.
This is a great photo too. You can see the eyes well. It's a little bit different when you know how swirly he is. Like you see all these little cute. And painting it with his favorite toy would be awesome too. This one's great.
You can't really go wrong.
I would think we can try this because we could actually see the tail a little bit, but with the tail as his in movement, so we could just look at another photograph. Here you can see the tail really well. I don't know, maybe I should just pick the sitting pose. I think it's great. And then we're discussing that we're not painting the background, we're just painting the dog. So let's say you just draw it out first and then paint it, or you can just go directly with paint. So maybe I'll choose this one.
Yeah.
Not all good, it's hard to choose. And then what I have here is regular acrylic paint. I got the all-purpose wipes, so Ollie can have some for her painting. Okay, so I hold like that.
That's perfect.
Cool. Okay, so drawing it out, I could use one of the markers that I got, or I could just go directly with paint.
You are very talented at sketching with paint. Just crazy.
Well, let's mix. Oops. keep on getting the shade they want. So here he's in the sun. I do not know if I need any purples. There are no purples in the brown. I definitely need white.
We'll always need white.
I might need a little tiny bit of the apricot.
Mm-hmm. He's like a nice golden toasted brown. Not golden, I guess. Bronze. Toasted bronze.
I have a bit of yellow. Because the other painting here, I would actually think of mixing brown with purple for tiny spots for the shade. Here, this was very exciting about painting all the directions and everything, but it might take forever. So I'm not sure it's good for the light. Okay, so this is the simple brush. I don't know if it's the brush I want to use. Let's see. Could be something like this. Okay. So I can start with a little thicker, and then I can move to detail. So that works really good. So I can mix brown and yellow and see what happens.
Get a little closer so we can get to the canvas.
Okay, so it's not bright enough. Some orange. A little tiny bit of red, but it's not too overpowering.
Oh yeah, that's
and that's
there.
Quite close already.
Mm-hmm. And you'll of course like refine the details and the lights and the darks like as you paint. But it's nice to have a good base to start.
Yeah, so let's start with this, and you know we can always tone it after it's painted. So I'm not getting to that. It can be a little tiny bit slightly different from what we begin with.
Okay. Let's see. I am going to City Central for a second because I need to go check on something.
Okay.
And you can see me run by in the back.
Maybe you'll get the better palette for yourself there.
Yeah,
which is
yeah, I'll do that one.
hopefully things didn't go off the rails without me.
How do you already have that?
Let's see what's going on. So from here, I would think I'll take the brush that is more important to me. And, I mean, this is, someone would call it a detail brush. For me, it's a thick brush. Like this. Okay, so now the shape.
What, I stepped away for 5 minutes and now we have a whole dog.
It's not just a dog, it's mom.
It's true. You're absolutely correct.
I'm not very experienced with painting dogs, and it's, again, every time is the first time for now, because I painted a dog when it was a pug first, and I painted Bobo, the Samoyed. And I would say with pugs, you do not have much experience with fur.
Yes.
So when I was painting the Samoyed dog, I would say it's the first time, because it's the dog with fur.
They're all very different dogs. The pugs are wrinkly. Samoy have long, fluffy hair. Monty has curly, really fluffy hair.
So we'll say I never painted a dog with hair like this.
So you're starting by mainly kind of outlining it, sketching it out a little bit?
Yes. So it's a little bit of the outline first. At least I see where I'm heading to, and then I can add some color. So I do not really follow the colors right now. I just put the something underneath, because you can see that it's light, but underneath there should be some contrast. So. Mm-hmm. Just putting brown here.
So I would just
basically go with where it's darker right now, and then I could add even a darker tone or shade.
How is yours going?
I'm still trying to mix the Monte color. It's a very particular kind of orangey brown that I've never done before.
Oh, your story is rushed. It's me too.
Yeah.
Okay. Whew.
I would take a thicker brush and I would go with basically where it's darker, but on a bigger area. So I would say I would just say this area is darker and I just have more.
This is brown.
Just brown for now. Here. Here is a little bit.
Okay, a little bit shifted. Here. Some brown. This is some brown. And right here. Just show some more brown.
And here. Okay. Shade, and we could just mark it as yellow, or we could just move on to a mixture of yellow with the shade we have. Not.
And we can play a little bit more with color here. Okay, and then we could
put white in the areas that are really light.
Do not forget
to clean your brush. So we're not thinking of curls too much yet. They're not still visible.
Yes and no, she would do it for the world.
Okay.
And then we would, anyway, the background would be added with time.
Mm-hmm.
So we can take it out right away. So here's the pool. So we can just add this. So we know that it's not part of a dog.
Mm-hmm. It's fluffy, but not that fluffy.
Not to that point. And then there is a little pool here. And then we need to add a little bit on this side. And then if we want to keep it clean, we would take it out as well on this side. So we can see the shape better than here. Okay, it goes right here. Oops. Is it still in the camera?
Yeah,
okay. Because I move it here and there, and then I'm at the end of the story. You cannot see what I'm
doing. Yeah, that's why I'm behind the camera here. I'm watching it. Except when I'm getting too distracted by my painting.
Okay. So. Let's see. So the background would be there anyway. It's just that I'm not using the line for painting the background, because it would be quite a lot of, too much.
A lot of process.
It looks close already. Not really focusing on colors yet, because the colors, since you add more and more and more, I'm not painting in two layers, I'm painting in more than two, and we can always add the tone or whatever we're painting. I'm focusing on just light and dark now, because otherwise, like, anyway, it would be changed in the process. So it's just the process, not exactly. So if there is yellow right now, it won't be yellow.
Mm-hmm.
As the result.
Let's start with the base and build up slowly.
So now we're thinking of how to actually show all these tiny curls.
Curls can be very hard to draw if you're not used to it. And I am not. I say that like I do know.
Thank you. Okay, so I need to mix more paint. So again, I'm moving in brown, white, yellow, orange.
Tiny bit of red. So I can just gather everything like this and use parts from here and there. So here is a little bit more yellow, so I would use that part for a lighter side. So I do not mix it completely. And then in this case, I would need to add a little tiny bit of. So here is the shade that I have. It's not as bright. Okay, so on this stage, we're still not thinking about the shade.
The way it turns out for now. It's easier to go with a more solid color to begin with and then move on to spots, like for myself personally in this case, and then show where light and dark is. So I guess from this it's easier to start in this particular piece.
Let's see, what do you think?
I guess you can say it's a dog and you can find where light is, where dark is.
It's definitely building up those layers.
Okay, so in this case, we need more white. We need black. And we need brown, that is a separate. So here, so I got the whole container of different shades, and then I could always add black. Black we need in any case, because the eyes and the nose need black. You see that I would have no other way to show the real nose.
Okay, and then
for the eyes, I would use black too.
Even though I could
leave it as brown, and I will see, maybe with time I would add more brown for that.
So now if I
want to create a really dark shade for outline and all these spots, I could mix brown and black and go from there, and then add this, all this mixed shades for actually going around it.
Let's see if there is a little bit more here. Then I just go with browns.
That's a good way. So here we would need to feel more than one time, because since we're feeling it, we can just add spots here and there to begin with.
Mm-hmm.
And then from this, from these spots we could find the dark and light. That's probably the easiest area to start with spots.
Yes.
And here we already look closer in which spot we're putting on. So this is a lighter shade right here. So we can pay more attention to where white is. We can wait until the next step. So, you know, you cannot completely remove the aspect of figuring things out, because each painting is different and you can work with the same image many times and still find something new for yourself.
Yeah. Art is an art. Art is an art, not a science.
So for me.
Yeah, so until we get to curls, it would take quite a long time, I guess. But I could possibly show on a smaller area. So here I just put some browns. And here I put some lighter shades. So on browns, I would just take parts of the pre-mixed. Something that I have. I don't know how can I call this. It's a lot of paint.
Yeah, pre-mixed. There are a variety of browns and
then just working with it with curls off here and there. And yes, the direction matters. And then if it's just white, it can always be added on to later, or it could be just toned right away. So we start adding to a little bit beyond, but it shouldn't be too far away. So it's, if it's the ear, I don't want it to go too far. I can just keep it in a little bit more. And all the curls might take some time, so I'm not painting it exactly the way it is, but I really want to finish it today.
Yeah. The idea is more to get a general Monty, not the exact version.
Thank you.
know, sometimes it's
hard to explain when you paint something, and I never think about how to explain it when I paint myself. Mm-hmm. So I would say just follow the direction of the curl at first.
Painting is a lot of observation, right?
Which is
looking and interpreting.
I moved it again.
Is it still in focus?
It's still in focus.
Yeah, okay.
So it would be really hard to show the whole picture on the line.
Yeah, we'll have to stop at some point, but once you kind of get the idea how far in are we? Yeah, we're a bit less than an hour. Yeah, a bit less than an hour.
Yeah, so the main
thing, the sketch is here already, and then it's quite a bit of working on these little details, which is, I don't know if it's even interesting to see like these little spots here and there, and then adding, I know a lot of artists would use white pen for tiny details.
Yeah, it's all a lot about just focusing and continuing and refining and all that jazz. Monty is a challenging dog to draw.
Yeah.
Zoom in a little closer before we finish up so you can see all of the all the fur is coming together, because the texture is looking really impressive.
texture will take some time, but it might be taking time of drying and coming back to it.
Mm-hmm.
It's definitely not time for the life, but I just keep adding little swirls first, and then some of them are really moving into some direction. So I would work with the direction as well, and then when it completely dries, I would possibly, not possibly, I need to come back to it, work on it. These are from Amazon, the set of 300, so if you want to check on how they look like and what you can do with them, you can just pop by and ask Marisa for. Also we have a couple of paint markers we brought, and this would be for the garden. And I do not limit ideas of what everyone wants to do, but the paint markers I brought for to paint parts and line shirts.
Yeah.
But if you
that's
want
right.
to do something.
That's right. We didn't mention that tomorrow is the national, September 30th is National Day for Truth and Reconciliation. So we will be closed on Monday for that. But we'll still be here on Friday next week. Although, yeah, we should be here on Friday. It's like, am I going to be here? Yes. More painting.
If you want to look at the texture, it's showing up a little bit, but it's not completely there yet.
Yeah.
Not. So you can see a little tiny bit of
it. Beautiful. It looks even nicer in real life, if you can believe that. But I love the texture you're getting at. It's looking.
Yeah, so it'll be there eventually.
Mm-hmm.
So. If not today, next week, Monday we are closed. The Portage Place is open.
Yes.
But we are closed.
Exactly. So we will see you then.
We'll get there. we have an extra day to think about painting.
Mm-hmm. To think about painting. Not to actually paint, but to think about painting him.
Yeah.
Okay.
It was nothing. For me, it's not an extra day because I'm not working. I do not work on Mondays.
Yes.
Anyway. And it's the, seriously now, it's a day to reflect.
Yes,
it's a day
absolutely.
To think about certain issues that are still there.
Yes, and we have posted some events that you can go to if you want to participate. They're not on our Studio Central account, but they are on our Artbeat account. So they're just reposts from Mama Way of activities and things going on in Winnipeg. So we hope that you can take a little time to support, reflect, whatever your role is in this. So.
Yeah, and yes, have a wonderful weekend. And yeah, again, time to think about certain things that are good to think about more than one day of the year, but this day will be good for that. And we'll see you next Friday.
Bye.